In this video, I'm going to share four different ways that you can use the Notion and Slack integration to help your team be more collaborative. Before you get started, you're going to want to make sure that you have the integration set up, and it's very easy to do so. On one of your database views, you're going to want to come to the three dots here, and then come down to Slack notifications. And I've already set mine up, but you'll have an option to connect your Slack workspace. It's a very straightforward integration that just takes a few clicks. You'll know that the integration is set up properly once you have the Notion app within your Slack workspace, and it says success, a new Notion workspace was connected. For the first way you can use this integration, I'm going to show you how to create Notion database items directly within Slack. So I'm going to type out a message here, and for this scenario, I'm going to say we're just going to create a note inside of my notes database. So let's say this is a random note, and we're going to send it, and then we're going to select the more actions button here, and then you can come down here and you can select send to Notion. Then you're going to search for your database. So the name of my database is called notes, and it's in this CRM here, and then we can give a title. Let's give it random notes. And then you can also select this here, which says confirm page creation publicly. I'm going to do that and then hit save. Once we've sent that, you can see that Notion has replied here and has said we have created a page from this message, and then it's linked that page so we can click into it. And then you can see it has that title that we entered, and it also did an embed here. So I just gave a very simple example of how you can use that database creation within Slack. But as you can imagine, there are a lot of other ways that you can use it. You could have a Slack channel where you have some of your customer interactions come in, and you could send that into Notion database. You could make sure that you're capturing some important things that some of your colleagues are saying. There's a lot of different things that you can do with it. The second way that you can use this integration is that you don't always have to send database items to Notion in order to capture some of this information that's within Slack. What you can do is you can come to the three dots here and you can copy the link, and then we're going to go embed this within Notion. So I've created this blank page, and what we're going to do is we're going to search for Slack, and then we're going to take that link that I got from Slack and we're going to paste it here, Slack link. And then you can see that this note has been pasted. And it doesn't have to be just on a random page like this. It could be tied to a specific record. So for example, here we have some contacts. I'm going to go to my contact here within my CRM. And if we wanted to make sure that we had the Slack communication tied to myself, we could do Slack and then paste this link. And then this is tied to my contact. The third way that you can use this integration is being able to preview Notion records within Slack. So I'm going to go up here on the specific contact record that I have within my CRM, but you can do this for any other specific record that you may have in your Notion database. And we're going to go ahead and grab this copy link. So I've went ahead and taken that link that we have in Notion and pasted it here in Slack, and you can see we kind of have a little bit of a preview here. Let's send it. It can take a little bit for this to go ahead and load the data. But you can share links with your colleagues here in Slack, and you can see the name of that contact record, which is myself, Ben Taylor. Then you can see some other information like who it was created by and the date that it was created. The last way to use this integration is perhaps the most useful, and that is sending Slack notifications whenever certain criteria is met within one of your Notion databases. So what I'm going to do here is whenever an opportunity, which an opportunity represents a deal within my CRM, is moved to closed one, meaning that we have won their business, it's going to send a Slack notification to a channel within Slack notifying the team that we have closed a deal. So I'm going to come up here and select these three dots, and then we are going to go down to Slack notifications, and we want to add a trigger. So I'm going to select add trigger, and then we are going to select stage, and then we only want this notification to be sent whenever a deal is closed one. So select close one, done, and then we're going to select the channel that we're going to send it to. So we're going just to send it to this channel called Opportunity Alerts. And then we're going to press create. Actually, one quick thing, you also can name these too. So I'm going to name this closed one alert and then hit save. Now we're going to move one of these deals to closed one, and then it's going to send a notification in Slack. I'm going to press closed one. So we're here in Slack, and I actually made the mistake of sending it to a private channel. I noticed that it has issues whenever you're sending it to a private channel, so make sure that you're sending it to an open channel. But here we're in Slack, and you can see that we have that notification. It says that the stage was changed from prospecting to closed one. And then if you want to go check out that record that was just closed one, or any of your other team members want to, just click this open in Notion button. then here's the deal that is closed one. So that's it for the different ways that you can use the integration between Notion and Slack. I think it's definitely very useful for teams to set up this integration, to be more aware of what is each other's progress on certain items within their Notion databases, and also just to be able to quickly view some things that might be in Notion just within a Slack channel. If you'd like more Notion tutorials like this in the future, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.